Gigi Scaria from Kerala. I did my bachelor's degree from Trivandrum College of Art, then I moved to Delhi in 1995. I did my master's degree from there. Mostly the interest of mine largely generates from the architectural spaces and cityscapes. That's something which is a major concern of my work. Kerala has a very specific geographical as well as cultural identity and context. From there, if you move to a megacity like Delhi, which actually has got a very different invitation for an outsider, and which actually has been worked a lot in my context and my specific understanding about the art, particularly. So the inspirations are mainly drawn from this part of the land, but then it actually processed differently while shifted to Delhi. Kerala has a very interesting artistic context, which actually certain intake which is very different from probably other parts of India. It has come because of the high literacy rate as well as the kind of atmosphere in which we critique and we understand and we respond to certain social situations in which, you know, we live in. And we actually create a lot of connection and dialogue between this day-to-day space and the political space in which we are all living. Trivandrum College has a very specific narrative school tradition, which actually pure abstraction in one sense, and the narrative very, you know, more like a storytelling method with a different approach. And you also have an inclination and a very specific saying about how you have to respond to the social, whatever happens in the social arena, which is actually have to be, you know, people will insist all the time that, you know, you have to have that kind of connection and reaction to the realities in which you live. Every bit of this information goes into your making and your thinking process, and which actually I think that's a kind of a major source and inspiration, as well as a stronghold of becoming an artist. Thinking about Venice Biennale, in fact, being a participant of 54th Venice Biennale, which was in 2011, and India had an official pavilion, and in which I was one of the artists who was invited and participated in that platform. I made an elevator which was made out of video installations combined, which is more like a video sculpture. You could go in and experience, which, you know, then it, you go inside the elevator and then the video backlit projections where make you feel that you're going up and down in an elevator space, and which you actually even get a little bit of dizzy feelings. Connecting and converting a space into an elevator, and yet again you are showing inside the elevator a local Indian household interiors of different houses, which actually discriminate or understand the social logic of different hierarchical structures which we all experience in daily life in Delhi. So that was quite an amazing experience for me myself, because I was also thrilled to see the response of the people, those of being inside the elevator, and when they came out and looking at me with a kind of a very different expression altogether. All of a sudden, when it comes to you as Biennale, as a platform in Kochi, which actually is perfectly ideally, and then we always think that, you know, we would have done it probably, you know, 25 years ago. So that kind of feeling comes in, because it's so perfect a space with very rich cultural heritage, as well as you know, all kinds of ambience and the cosmopolitan culture Kochi has. Here it is much more a challenging space you have to interact with. And at the same time, also then, you also know that, you know, your audience you're facing are not a normal ones. You know, you're not actually addressing a random audience. You are addressing a specific audience. They are here for to see the work. So I'm really thrilled, at the same time looking forward to see what I can make out of it, and the expectations and the level of ambition is higher, as well as the level of understanding from the other side, you know, how that will be received is also in a very ambiguous, you know, situation. It's very interesting to see the how the cultures incorporate a certain kind of specificity in terms of their living, and how that particular cosmopolitanism kind of travels in a universal sense, and it actually meets in pockets and different parts of the world, and then you actually connect with this place so sudden and easily. That's something which is a feel. It's a great feel.